Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in a recent live stream, someone said, why can't you use hierarchies when you create field parameters? And I was like, I think I have an idea on how you can simulate the use of hierarchies with field parameters. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, someone asked this very specific question about using hierarchies with field parameters. And you're like, hey, whenever I go to create my field parameter, the hierarchy is grayed out. If you don't know what field parameters are, there's great documentation. I think we have about 2 videos on our YouTube channel that you can go watch, so we'll check them out. This is something really specific, and they're right. You cannot use hierarchies. I tried it. But have a way, a little workaround that I want to show you in this video. All right, so you guys know how we like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So check this out. In my model, I have 2 hierarchies, one for product category and one for sales continent. And what I like to enable my report consumers to do is switch between those hierarchies. Right now, you'd have to go into edit mode to switch, but they're just report consumers. We don't give them elevated access. So how do we enable that? Let me show you. So you go to modeling, and if you go to new parameter, go to fields, and then we're going to change this to dynamic hierarchy, and then we're going to add the fields. Now, let me show you what he was talking about. If I go to product, you'll notice that category hierarchy is completely disabled. If I expand it out, I can see the order of the things. And that's what you want to do. You want to drag each item into the add and reorder fields list as they appear in the hierarchy. So in my case, it would be category, subcategory, and it would be product name. See how they match the hierarchy? And then repeat it for all subsequent hierarchies that you want to include, that you want to allow your report consumers to switch between. So I'm going to go here. So you can see sales continent, sales country. I'm going to drag sales continent, and I'm going to drag sales country. Not going to add a slicer. Click create. So what I'm going to do is go to this slicer, and I'm going to drop it right there. So you can see all those, and then I'm going to go to my matrix, get rid of the hard coded, the explicit hierarchy, and I'm gonna use my dynamic hierarchy right here. You can see it rolls it up. And if I wanted my report consumers to use this, by default, it's using these values, right? And it's going all the way down, all the way down. But what I wanna do is I only wanna include the items from the product hierarchy. So what I would do is enable multi-select on my slicer, and now you can see it works. But now my report consumers, they need to know this. Or we can clear this out, and if they wanted to just use sales continent, they can do that. But that's not efficient. I want to make this really easy for them so they can say product hierarchy, drops them all in. Sales continent hierarchy, it drops them all in. I could toggle between the two. Let me show you what I did. Go over to this dynamic hierarchy, and you can see it's just some DAX, and it's a table constructor, and within each table constructor, it's a row called a tuple, and it's just 3 columns. The name that's going to be displayed, the value, and then the sort order, and it repeats it. And notice each one of these tuples, they actually have the same number of columns. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a 4th. So right after that sort order, I'm going to say product hierarchy. And then I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to add it right after each sort order. And now if I try to finish this, I'll get a nice little error saying each tuple in the table constructor must have the same number of columns. That's because these 3 have 4 and these 2 only have 3. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sales continent hierarchy. I'm going to copy it. Go right here, paste it in there. Then I'm gonna hit my check. Everything will come back to life. And now you can see everything is still here, but I'm gonna make one quick change to this slicer. Let's clear everything out. Now on my dynamic hierarchy table, I have value 4. So that is actually the grouping. So I'm gonna drop that right on top. And now you can see how it rolls up. So if I expand this out, you can see that category, subcategory, and product name rolls up to product hierarchy, the same thing with sales continent. So if I choose this one, you see if when I start drilling in, it only goes down to the product name level. And then if I go to sales continent, it does the exact same thing. And I'm giving my report consumers the same look and feel and the same capabilities that they would have if there was a hierarchy, but using this through field parameters. I think it's a pretty cool workaround. It would be great if I just could drag hierarchies, but you can't right now. And that's all right. With this little DAX workaround, you should be able to solve this problem. All right. What do you guys think? You got any questions? You got any comments? You solved this a different way? I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.